Hi guys, I just finished the HB90 course and I'm nearly done planning for quarter two. All I have left to do is put my tasks into my Notion dashboard. After my last video, some of you asked to see my HB90 Notion setup, and I said I'd do a full tutorial in this quarter planning video, but then Sarah Cannon made a great and pretty comprehensive tutorial. So I don't think I need to go into as much detail myself, especially because I did pretty closely follow what Sarah did in her video. But I did personalize the dashboard to better fit my goals and my personality. So I'll show you how I set mine up, and hopefully it gives you ideas for your own. So I went ahead and started planning as soon as I knew what I was going to be doing for YouTube this quarter. I had like a general sense of what I'd be doing, so I wanted to go ahead and get that down before it left me. And so that's why I already have some quarter two stuff here. But I hadn't gone through the course when I put these in. So now I'm gonna like refine it a little bit. And also I'm going to put in the stuff that I came up with while I did the course this week. So that's first on my list of things to do. I went ahead and wrote out the tasks within each project in the HB90 planner. I haven't had a chance to set up my Kanban board yet, but I'm going to go ahead and put everything into Notion just to make it easier on myself, especially because I still have my Kanban board set up for last quarter, which we're still currently in, actually, quarter one. So I don't feel that bad about it, but I'm going to wait until the end of next week to build the Kanban board, but I'm going to go ahead and do it in Notion now. I don't know how long this draft actually is going to be. I'm just going to put 50K for now to account for it. I may have to increase that over time, but it's okay with me if I only get 50K revised this round. I think maybe I can just duplicate this for the final draft, but I'm not sure. Let me try that. Yay. Okay, so we'll change this one to final draw and just drag it. There we go. Okay, I've got my logs in here. I'm gonna filter this so I only see goal two to make this easier. Okay, so I put a lot of thought into how I'm going to do the weekly videos once I've completed the challenge. I had initially numbered them something like video 35 through like 40 something. But then that gets a little too complicated. So instead, what I've decided to do is restart numbering at 1 and add 0.2 to each number to mark the second quarter. And I'll do that every quarter to keep things consistent. So in quarter two, I'll be posting video 1.2 through 9.2. And each video will have an associated plan, film, edit, and post task along with it. Okay, that's it for goal two tasks. I do have more of a sense of the timeline with these than I do with the goal one tasks right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and just put those dates in now. I'll worry about the dates for goal one later. And that should do it. We're all set up for goal two. Goal three in quarter one was writing a poem or short piece every week. And since I'm doing the daily poetry challenge in April, I went ahead and put poems there. But as I was planning the course this week, I decided to make goal three in quarter two more health-based. I'll be shooting for 240 exercise minutes every week and 70 out of 90 days eating at my calorie goal. But I'm going to be tracking that on the dashboard. So let's go to the dashboard now. This is everything that Sarah covered in her tutorial, with a few cosmetic differences because I like yellow more than pink. I just followed along and created this, right down to this quote, which I love and found pretty easily. So if you want to know how to build this part of it, watch Sarah's video. But now I'm going to show you what I added to fit my own needs. And I did mostly use free templates that I adjusted, so I'll link everything I talk about below, and I'll talk you through how I adjusted it. So I kept a lot of things from Sarah's video. This widget, this calendar, daily tasks, weekly tasks, this GIF, end of quarter, this quote again. I added this quote using AI. I just had the Notion AI give me a motivational quote and put it here. I added a reading list using the standard media template. Building this and making it work for me took a lot of work, more than I think it should have. And honestly, I don't remember much of it, so I can't walk you through it because I started also using this. And this was the only template that I actually bought. I think it was like $8 on Etsy. But it's a really cute bookshelf template that you can use to keep track of everything that you're reading. And I love these little status bars that tell you how far you are in every book. I added these graphics here. If you know me at all, you know that I'm a super pessimistic person most of the time. So I'm working hard to be more positive this quarter. And then here I have my planned writing and my planned videos. And this is just a place where I can easily go to see what's coming up. And then I track meals here for the week. I've been very poorly doing this, so it's not very populated, but I did go ahead and put this in to give you a sense of how. And I think maybe the adjustments here were the hardest. This is my watching list of things that I'm currently watching or just recently finished. I can give it a score here. Change the status. I mentioned before that I was going to be tracking my health goal here. I built this widget through Indiffy, and it's just the simple counter widget. So that's how I'll be keeping track of my health goal up here. And I created this table that has days of the week on it. And every time I complete both goals, I'll just like hit plus here. And then I have a reward schedule so that I can keep track of how many days I've hit and also reward myself. And this is my list of rewards. Don't make fun of me. And then I have another tracker here, also from Indiffy, though I used arrows here instead of the plus and minus for some reason. Not sure why. And this is to track my rejections. If you watched my submission spreadsheet tutorial, you might remember the Unfortunately challenge from Adrian Dawes, the playwright. Basically, the Unfortunately challenge is just a challenge to accumulate 100 rejections within one calendar year. I've racked up 5 so far this year. It's been pretty great so far because I've also gotten 2 acceptances, so that's fun. I also have a rejection tracker here. This is another toggle list that I built with the help of AI. And you can imagine that this would be a lot harder without the help of AI. Not hard so much as just tedious because it is 100 rejections. And then I have a fill the well section, which is also something that Sarah recommends for days when your energy might be lower or you're just having a bad day. So I just kind of populated this with ideas I had to recover on days like that. Then I have a prayer tracker where I keep track of my prayers. This is showing the days of Ramadan, which started yesterday. Now we'll look at this side. I have my planned writing, planned videos, and this is really just so that I have these in the back of my mind as I'm working. I have my meal planner, which was free, but I did have to adjust it to show calories. I think that might have been the most difficult thing I had to do. And then I have some planning tools down here. I have ambient sounds that I can play, all of these different sounds. And this is just a website that I embedded. And then I have a Pomodoro timer, which I adjusted to 30 minutes because I prefer 30-minute increments. And then my short breaks are 5 minutes, my long breaks are 15, and I can just track them right here. And then I set up my second brain below. And this also took a lot of time. Honestly, I'm not anywhere close to done with this. I'm still doing research on it. I find the entire concept of a second brain very fascinating, and I can't wait to dig in. But I literally just started this like yesterday. So it might be a while before this is populated and becomes actually useful to me.
Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful. I'll be sure to link everything I mentioned in the description, so definitely check all that out. And if you find that you have questions while you're setting things up, let me know and I'll make a more in-depth tutorial. Take care and see you next week.